that is the most difficult part, that is strictly default solves. Like, default solves root. And it's the most difficult by a long, long way. It's about as difficult as, well, it's less difficult than the optimal way to do heli skip for default souls, which is much more difficult than any percent. So I haven't been doing it. My A button occasionally seems like it's dying.
Yeah, this is DJ Professor K, baby. The master of mayhem, know what I'm saying? Bring you another Tokyo Underground Pirate Radio broadcast from Jet Set Radio. I'm gonna bust into your head through your cute little ears and blow your mind with my sexy voice and out-of-sight sounds. Those of you prone to nosebleeds should keep those tissues handy, suckers. Tokyo is being oppressed by the Rokkaku Group, a mega enterprise headed by Rokkaku Goji. Rokkaku is using his money and influence to mess with everything, industry, society, and even our culture. And he's even got his eyes set on City Hall. Lately, Rokkaku's been shaking down the government, passing that Rokkaku law crap, even buying off the police department. This law ain't nothing but garbage. It's just some selfish little punk's way of trying to show he's a big man. Rokkaku and his gang are trying to stomp out our culture left and right. They don't give a rip about our rights. All they care about is profit. And some spineless fools have already become flunkies in their diabolical scheme. You better believe they're listening on this broadcast. But even in all this heat, there's a group of young kids who are tearing up the streets. I'm talking about the Rudas. These kids are set out to bury Tokyo in graffiti. And now they're all wrapped up in their own little territorial tug of wars. The hottest team at the moment is the GGs. There's Yo-Yo, a guy who blow your mind with silver tongue. And Gum, a real cool lady who leaves a trail of broken hearts wherever she goes. And let's not forget their leader, a self-styled genius.
I can't actually remember which one is which. Whether option A is cutscenes or not. The attack on the record store in Chuo. I don't even know which one we went from. Prowlers in Dogenzaka Hill, lowlife spreading vicious rumors. The mysterious blackout on 99th Street. That's the boss from Jet Set Radio on Dreamcast. Is this a remake? Okay, so with the Rokkaku Expo just around the corner, this is not a remake. It's kind of a sequel, but not really. I mean, it's kind of a reimagination of Jet Set Radio. Game's gonna start soon, and y'all gonna be the one making the plays.
Yo, all right, let's get this party started. I'll be your audience, so let's see what you got. Someone done stole the goddess of the streets, the statue of Dogenzaka Hill. I bet the punks who did this are the same ones who are spreading all the nasty rumors.
I've never even played Jet Set Radio on the Dreamcast, which is kind of weird since I have world record for it, but yeah. I think Megatherium, who had his run like 12 years ago or something like that, did on Dreamcast, kinda had to.
You got a great Flush out those rumor spreading punks. Give them my regards.
Yeah, you can play Jet Set Radio on Dreamcast, PC, 360, maybe like PS3 or something like that. But you can only play JSRF on an original Xbox, an Xbox 360, or CXBXR, which is a PC emulator for the original Xbox. So you basically can play JSRF on a PC. It's not perfect, but it's very, very close to the actual game. Basically indistinguishable, apart from a few very minor differences. Right, yeah.
スケート走行中の少年を確認。現在道玄坂付近を移動中。近い局は現場へ急行せよ。
Yo, the Rukaku Group's dogs just showed. I've never actually used CXBXR. But I think that it's something that you need a pretty good computer for it to work properly. One thing I don't know is, I think it might do. Does CXBXR have the glitchy Shibuya graffiti thing? Like one of the graffitis you can only spray if you're like jumping through it. This is or wall riding the city's on biggest that part. Non-stop dance party. Let's hit this joint and cover up that freaky looking graffiti. If any people here know the answer to that, that'd be cool.
Damn! It's poison jam! I can't believe they're showing that ugly faces in broad daylight. Shame on them. Are they the ones behind all this?
It seems like you do need to get all of the quick turns, including the last one, which is kind of annoying, to get the best cycle here. That was really fast then. One thing I forgot about is the extremely kind of awkward bus jump you can do there. That may or may not be faster. Probably is if you do it perfectly though. Incredibly awkward. Wow, the gold. Yeah, that was an incredibly good Shibuya terminal.
The station feared and revered by both man and our beast. Jet Set Radio, citizens of the underworld. This is your king speaking. Stop what you're doing and listen up. Seems that Poison Gem graffiti contains a lethal poison, makes people laugh themselves to death. They followed up their performance at Shibuya Terminal with encores at Chuo Street and in Rokkaku Dai Heights. Those Poison Gem punks got as much attitude as they are ugly. And Poison Gem has been heating up the streets with their rivalry with the queens of 99th Street. Rapid 99! These ladies hate seafood with a passion,
poison jam like cats and dogs. If you can find them out there in the streets, they might slip you some information. And then there's Hayashi, the Rokkaku police force's own personal version of hell on earth. I mean, even his own partner's afraid of him, because when he loses it, there ain't no telling who he'll shoot at. I mean, he's crazy. Check this out. Just the other day, he freaked out and trashed a patrol car. And why, you may ask? Because one of his subordinates went to buy him his favorite mint candy and came back with coffee flavor instead. Stop with this fool. Wake up the neighbors. Are you hearing this or what? Is your heart pounding with the beat? Am I getting through to you? Show me what you got. I'm counting on y'all.
I'm probably gonna get tanked.
This is Chuo Street, the heart of Tokyo's entertainment district. Now get out there and bury Poison Jam's nasty graffiti and paint.
That was pathetic.
Streets are turning into a demilitarized zone. I don't think them combat vehicles have to obey traffic signs. Take out them nasty iron behemoths.
Thank you.
like those little beast dudes have arrived. Please don't feed the animals.
This pace is actually absurd.
This is Rokkaku Dai Heights, an abandoned hill that time forgot. Poison Jam's always growling around here. Bury it in graffiti and put the smackdown on Poison Jam.
That was very fast, I think. This is a sub 27.
9th Street, the city's hottest nightlife scene, centering around Benton Tower. Here is just one bloody showdown after another, because it's where the mafia kingpins keep their offices. And there's been some bad stuff going down lately, ever since the mysterious power outage. And Rapper 99 seems to have made this their home. All right, my people, it's time to give 99th Street a new paint job.
That graffiti section was actually perfect, which is nice and pretty rare.
Poison Jam's worst enemy, Rapid 99, has been seen on 99th Street. Well, I guess it just takes a little persuasion to get info from the Queens at 99th Street.
Okay, I think we're gonna get sub 33. Or rather, we will if I don't do something stupid.
adding new dimension to your life every day in a stylish and funky way. Jet Set Radio.
I really want to know how much difference there is up to this point between Any Percent and Default Souls. Like, the only two differences are you don't get the tape in Dogen, which means that you don't have to unlock it. Picking it up isn't relevant yet. And the other thing is you have to get the extra RDH soul.
Well, from what I heard, Poison Jam's got a boss, and anyone who can organize.
But I think basically this paste might be just absolutely nuts. If it was like converted to 20%, but I'm not sure. Kinda confused, honestly.
Poison Jam's home turf, and I don't think they like strangers up in their house, you know what I'm saying?
I really hope that Cucumber is only possible with Combo. Because that means it's not going to happen accidentally. Like, I'd be down if it was just a combo, because, I mean, it would be kind of horrible, but it would mean that you need to, you know, it kind of happened accidentally, I guess. It would still be faster, even with some of the slow getting to places and whatnot, and then switching again in bottom point, I assume, but it would be way faster still. I feel like it's possible we wouldn't have to swap in bottom point, but I'm not really sure. I really doubt you can do the. In fact, I'm basically positive you can't do the fastest version of the clip with this combo.
You got a great baby song.
instrumental, feeding you vitamins.
The station that's so smooth, your ears won't even know what hit them. Jet Set Radio! The GGs have penetrated into the Tokyo Underground sewage facility and crashed Poison Jam's little sewer party. Their boss, Q, got away, but it was obviously Poison Jam who kidnapped the statue. Now why'd they go and do a thing like that? Whoa! This just in! GG's member, Yo-Yo, has just disappeared! No ransom note, no threatening phone calls, nothing! I mean, what's going on here? In other news today, the new team, the Noise Tanks, just arrived in the scene and are flexing some serious muscle. Word is that the Noise Tanks are a bunch of cyborgs. They all got mechanical bodies and whatnot. And the Immortals, who used to control the skyscraper district, just got their butts handed to them by the Noise Tanks and had to give up their turf. The Noise Tanks are bringing one street team after another under their control. And pretty soon, they're gonna be running wild all over the city. You gotta be a fool to think this ain't got nothing to do with Yo-Yo's little disappearance. Rough up those Immortals a little, and they might help you unravel this mystery.
Just the other day, the love shockers of Hikage
gum is used because for most of this run at least, she's the best option, and it's because of her cornering. Cornering is by far the most important stat in speedrunning this game. Like, graffiti, acceleration, whatever, like, make almost no difference, realistically. Cornering makes a huge difference. We use, okay, that almost never happens. That's a lot of time off. Okay. I don't really know what to do because that's so weird. That hasn't happened in actually ages, maybe over a year. Any reason, but yeah, basically, cornering. But we use clutch later on because he can hold 5 extra cans, and that is really helpful for some of the later boss fights. It actually saves loads of time if you have those extra cans compared to if you don't. So even though he has worse cornering, it's worth it.
Run away, little bugs. Go cry to your mamas.
Old strats. I don't even know what to do, honestly. That's what it feels like. Anyway, I'm losing a lot of time on Hikage, clearly. A lot of time. Okay, dude, really one can short.
Got a great soul.
boosted. I'm so glad I didn't. But yeah, it's kind of stupid how little difference acceleration actually makes. If it was speed, I feel like that could be more interesting. But it would kind of force you to use certain characters for test runs. But I mean, the game already does, so. Yeah. It'd be interesting. Percent when okay, this is actually really interesting that you brought up pots. First thing is that you can only get pots after the game's finished, so you can't like do like a run, I guess, like a main game run with pots. Not in that way at least. But this gets a lot more interesting when you think about Jet Set Radio, as in the original, because pots in Jet Set Radio is pretty much the worst character, kind of, because he can only hold 7 cans at a time. Most characters in Jet Set Radio can hold like 20, I guess, 20, 25, that's kind of the average. And being only able to hold 7 is just awful. But there is a way you can repeat the story indefinitely in JSR after you finish the main game with the different characters. So people have thought about trying to actually route a run where you basically do all the main levels with pots, so you have almost no cans at any given time. It's a really interesting idea, but nobody's really put much time into it yet. Luckily, I was already on a really good pace, so it's not horrendously bad, but it is really bad still. That was weird. This is way less time lost than it feels like it should be, not a lie. Feels like it should be like a minute, or like 40 plus seconds. I mean, I know my gold isn't good, but still.
With the noise tanks controlling the Immortals, they managed to spread their turf all the way out here. Bury all the Immortals' graffiti in your own tank.
I really hope I don't fuck this up. I do not want another run that dies on the keeper split. Because that's happened way too many times. Okay. I think we're gonna make it. And we have a good amount of cans, so that's nice. Okay. I what was that with the cactus switch? Okay, I was executing a thing called heli-skip, and it's actually extremely difficult to do it right, pretty much. Put it this way, on the gameplay I just did, if I had done it half a second slower, the run would be over. Even a quarter of a second slower, the run might have been over. It is extremely close, at least on the Japanese version, and this way of doing it. Basically, the way it works, and this is the way quite a lot of stuff in this game works, enemies, like cop fights, only kind of spawn, like they can only be activated after the dialogue of the cop talking has finished. So basically, by switching characters, there are other ways you can do this, like going in and out of the same area, but by switching characters, what it does is that it resets the cop dialogue. So we can use that to then basically take advantage of it and beat the area where the helicopters spawn in this case. So normally I'd have to go around the map and spray to death 4 helicopters. But because of the whole character switching stuff, it basically just skipped that. Okay, come on, I want to get this jump for fuck's sake. There's a difficult jump coming up that ruined the run last time. So, yeah, let's see if the same thing's gonna happen or not. It might well be the hardest bit in the entire run. Okay, I barely got it. Thank fuck, dude. Thank fuck. Okay, well, we've got past the hardest part of the run, so, yeah, that's kind of cool. And I think on the best pace I've ever had, this Kibo split is fake, so, yeah, I'm not actually losing ages. Doesn't mean it was great either, it just means it wasn't that bad.
This right here is the skyscraper district in Pharaoh Park, an open-air garden built by some rich Egyptian dude living in Tokyo. And the holy
sanctuary. I actually haven't got this far in ages.
Do me a favor, give the immortals.
Because I keep on messing it up at the like bit I was just in. The heli skip and the jump are pretty cool. Although I used a slightly easier, actually it's quite a lot easier version of heli skip, because I just, the amount of times I missed it, even when I basically did it perfectly, with the faster method is bad. Yeah, so you I do still get slowdowns in 99th Street, but the main thing is that the Xbox 360 version of the game has a lot more problems with slowdowns than the original Xbox version, which is the version I'm playing. So I do get slowdowns, but it's nowhere near as bad as on the 360. Honestly, that's a pretty weird death walk, not gonna lie. Doesn't really make sense. I barely picked up any cans. Great. Yeah, the text in this game can get pretty weird. Like, if you win a death ball race or whatever, sometimes, I think on the first time it says a GG win out, which is clearly just a crap translation. 16 cans. Okay, I think I tested it out and he didn't actually have to jump there, but I'm not gonna risk it. This is possibly my favorite part of Default Souls. Hello Kyla, welcome back. Oof, that's sad actually. Fucking yikes, dude. Oh my god. Yeah. I haven't done that before. Fuck. Whatever. It's not too bad. But it is pretty sad. I'm just going a bit too fast. Whatever. Oh, come on, dude. What is this bullshit? Yeah, very, very slow SDPP. Fuck me, dude.
Watch out, or else they'll turn you into
one of their own.
Spray the backs of those involved punks.
This is probably your all-time favorite game. Well, then you have good taste, obviously. And cans. Fuck. I'm not gonna boost. I'm gonna do it. Also, I don't wanna fucking die. But yeah, I lost ages. Yeah, it actually has a fairly active fan base, honestly, like, oh, fuck me, dude, what? I've never fucking done that before. It's not my memory. Okay, it's not that bad, but it's just ridiculous. Like, it's not actually too shit, but just more bullshit time loss. But yeah, speedrunning community is actually pretty big for a fairly rare game. Like, I think there's about, what, 60, 70, any percent runs on the leaderboard? I don't want you to hear Jet Set Radio!
The GG's fell for the Immortals trap, hook, line, and sinker, baby. The Immortals sure played it smooth.
But yeah, quite a lot of the,
Guess maybe they are royalty after all.
Quite a lot of the remaining and existing community is, the speedrunning part of it. But there is still quite a lot that isn't.
The members of the noise tanks have just jacked into the power supply of the stadium, which is being built.
Speedrunning is when you play a game and basically you try and do it as fast as possible. That's basically it. But obviously there are people like me who spend thousands of hours on stuff to try and get it a bit better. Yeah, if you do, then I think you'd probably like speedrunning. Slow runners. I mean, literally, all you have to do for it to count as a speedrun is legit look at a clock, play the game, finish it, and look at a clock again. That's literally it. Like, that's the most basic form of speedrunning. How'd I clip through? Basically, there's an area where you can, like, jump from a quarter pipe, and you can, it basically kind of pushes you through. It's very simple, nothing difficult. And we actually use it in the run. So yeah. This is a pretty new thing actually. For Death Ball, the first round, we just do the race. But for the second and third round, we do something quite different. We clip out of bounds, throw the ball away, which basically makes the AI for the Immortals and Love Shockers, like, die pretty much, and then you bonk them to death. You just run into them until they die, and if you do it well, it's actually fast enough than racing them. It's faster than racing them. But it's only worth it for Love Shockers and Immortals, because they have very low health, and Doom Riders have a lot more health, so it's just not worth it for them.
GG's win! The Doom Riders have been knocked out cold. Can't collect insurance in hell, boys.
Don't mind Quack Thing. It's just overexcited command makers.
Time for round deuce. The bringers of the seven plagues, the Immortals. Versus the GG's, back for more.
Okay, hopefully I can get this. The clip is very easy to get if you have unlimited time, but it is sometimes difficult if you only have one attempt at it. And you have to get it twice in a row, really. Okay, there we go. Throw the ball away. They basically just stop now. And then you basically just run into them like this until they die. And if you do it perfectly, it can be over 10 seconds faster than just racing them. It does take a while. And then you just repeat it with Love Shockers. Although with Love Shockers, you want to end with 30 cannons instead of, like, however many you end with this one with. This can actually be quite difficult because they can sometimes, like, pretty much not take damage. You didn't even know they could be killed. Yeah. I didn't know until this strat was a thing, which has only been, like, a month or so. Maybe 2 months. I didn't even know that you could win by killing them. I didn't even know you could kill them either. Really? So yeah.
Oh, wouldn't you know it? The GG's again!
Alright now, the GG's are finally starting to slow down. That's gotta be a part of the Noise Tank's game plan.
Okay, so this time, I just take a slightly different route at the beginning to make sure I end with 30 cannons, which is the max you can have at this point for this character. Okay. Now, it's one of the things you have to be careful about is you can't just throw the ball, like, randomly. It has to be in the right direction because it can actually bounce off the wall outside, And if that happens, it can, okay, it can actually go back in, basically, and they will carry on going after it, so you have to be kind of careful when you throw the ball. But this is actually quite slow, because sometimes when you, like, run into them, they don't actually take damage, pretty much. And it's not random, it's just kind of, you have to do it right, but it can be quite difficult at times to do it fast enough. But that was still pretty good, I think.
Oh, no. The game's been interrupted. They've been surrounded by the Rokkaku police. Man, who called
but if you do it perfectly, it would be nice like if you do the fastest watch, method no. We know of right this, and you do it perfectly for both races, it can save about 28 seconds over just racing them. That's combined. Each time can save about 14 seconds, so yeah. It's actually super worth it. Even though it can be annoying, because you can have times where they kind of don't really want to get hit, and you can end up losing a lot of time. Thanks for the follow, the Nebuchadnezzar. That's as close as I can get.
The Rokkaku police's terror drone showed up again. Get rid of them for good this time, man. I'm telling you.
Now, I don't think there was a pop-up on screen, like an alert, so... yeah, that means that something isn't working quite right. But, yeah.
Those things ain't nothing but scrap metal now.
I'm not too surprised. Okay, I'm supposed to skip through this. Well... yeah, but yeah. It should pop up, but whatever. Also, thanks for the follows, Milo Aquarius TV, thank you.
Yo-Yo's gutsy plans got messed up by those idiot Rokkaku police.
But yeah, it should really come up with an alert on screen, so.
The noise tanks look pissed. They must have fried some.
I don't really know what's happening with that, but.
Is there anyone out there who can stop those rampaging machines?
Okay, I would argue that this next split is the most movement heavy part in the entire game. Like, if you want to get good at movement, this is the bit to practice. Because people talk about how, like, RDH has, not RDH, FRZ has super crazy movement, and it does, but it's more a few big things. It is quite a few, but yeah. With this, like, the entire thing is getting good at movement, pretty much. There's so many intricacies to doing this bit fast. But there are some I miss, because it's just better, really. They take too long to get them at that point. Or rather, there are better ones to get later on. Okay, it's kind of weird how you can get the thing where gum almost, like, turns back, I guess. Doesn't actually matter, I don't think, but it's kind of weird, honestly. Okay. I would not want that to happen in a damage list run. I really wouldn't. Okay. Let's see if I can get the other bus jump. And I did. Nice. Okay. That's actually really bad. Could have been a lot better if I didn't randomly miss those two. Because I'm kinda low on those tanks right now, I think. I'm gonna have to probably get most of the ones at the top of 99th Street, honestly. I'll probably go for all of them. Which is pretty slow. Kind of weird. There's quite a few there, honestly. Okay. This is kind of what I wanted. I think I've only got this guy to do that. Okay. If there was actually one more, that would have been super bad, not gonna lie. I would have had to go back down. And that would have been pretty painful. But I did it right, so it's good. Okay, let's see if I can do this. Cool.
That's good.
Maybe it could be faster to boost there, I'm not really sure. That was a kind of wasted boost, honestly.
The roars of the ancient dragons still echo.
Actually, I really like this part of Default Souls as well.
Sky Dinosaurian Square. Now, according to Poison Jam's info, Yo-Yo is biding his time up there. Go find him.
Okay, I don't think I'm gonna take full damage here. I went like down the ramp a bit, so that was less of a fall, so I didn't take the damage. Doesn't really matter much, but it's kinda sweet at the same time.
The
time to kick some booty, y'all. Defeat that
kid. Kind of funny how you can do all that before the fight even starts. I think if you can get the tape, then you can probably do all that as well. Maybe that's a soul percent or 100% thing, I'm not sure. Probably not though, because you have to go back for the graffiti, so yeah, probably not.
His cover's been blown. It was nothing but an imposter. He overheated with anger. Looks like the noise tanks are behind all this.
I'm not gonna go for extra cans. Not this time around. Okay. Fast. Honestly, I really can't stand the jump that Subrix does at the end to get to the fight, I guess. That jump is awful.
Jet Set Radio! We're kicking it live, even in the furthest reaches of the galaxy.
Like, it's harder than... I think it's harder than Quikage and Suicide Soul without the suicide bit.
Yo-Yo's real identity was nothing but a noise tank in disguise. Check this out.
I don't really know what the pace is, but whatever. I can have a look, I guess.
They kidnapped Yo-Yo and built a fake one to try and destroy the GGs. And since the Rokkaku police couldn't take care of the Rudies on their own, the Rokkaku group has sent in the Golden Rhinos, their own little secret special forces group, to tear up the streets. The Golden Rhinos are a group of highly trained assassins brought together by Rokkaku Goji, the ringleader of the Rokkaku group and Tokyo's current mayor. Hayashi has been kicked out of his useless police organization. He's gotta be freaking out by now. The noise tanks have been wiped out. But now, the gang that got implanted with Noise Tanks' brainwashing chip is after the GGs. Where in the world could the real Yo-Yo be? Defeat the Golden Rhino goons and find Yo-Yo!
Okay, I don't know. Bro, wouldn't it be funny if you didn't have enough souls and default souls for Clutch? Oh yeah, I didn't really see the comment. Yeah, it is kind of funny that they start dancing when they're about to be bashed to death, pretty much. Kind of weird. Oh yeah, there are some bits where we use corn. When we're going to switch characters again. And we have to use Yo-Yo for chapter 1, because, I mean, we can switch to gum, but it's just not worth it. It takes too much time for it to be worth it. I really don't know how I have so many cans, but whatever. Maybe I picked up some or something. Probably. Kinda not sure, honestly. I don't think I should have trick jumped there, though. Okay, I can tell you the pace in a bit.
The Golden Rhinos are planting a time bomb somewhere in the fortified residential zone. First, spray the blue device and stop that timer.
Okay, come on, dude.
First, spray the blue device to stop it.
Fuck, ladder jump. Sorry, ladder jump. Please don't take it personally and stop me from getting you ever again. That would be pretty bad. Oh yeah, I'm gonna learn ladder jump for any percent, because I mean, I need every second I can possibly get. Dude, not again. Not again. Not again, motherfucker, really? I basically did that in my any percent PB, but only once rather than twice. I lost like 12, 13 seconds, maybe not as much, something like that. I don't know. It wasn't too horrendous, but it was pretty bad. Not gonna lie, it was pretty bad. Okay, so the pace is. About.
See how well you fare a second time.
The pace is about 2 minutes and 30 seconds ahead of the official world record, as in Sudfix's time. But yeah, that's not like the actual world record, I guess, even though it hasn't been verified. Because I don't have a video. So yeah, this should be a 145. But there's a good chance I'm gonna fuck something up, honestly. It really is. I love this track.
There you go. You stop the timer.
I like feather jump more, but I don't know if it's faster. And if it is, it's kind of not worth, honestly. Not if we can do it that way. That was a pretty bad Aaron jump, but I'll take it. Do I need two cans?
Heads up! You got Golden Rhinos incoming! I guess they didn't like you messing with the time.
Usually I like to have at least 23, but I think it's okay. It can be hard to tell because, like, a lot of things in this game can, like, stuff that isn't actually sprays can often take up like extra cans, it seems, for like no reason. Okay, massive gold out of nowhere. Lol.
Jet Set Radio. Whether you're chilling on your couch or in your coffin, don't forget to tune us in to keep you company.
Okay, the only way I know I can save time over Subprick is with the big metal thing jump, but that's pretty difficult.
Now I'm the star at the top of their black list, cause I gave you the
It doesn't matter really if I don't get it there.
This is the first time
think.
I've been on top since the burping contest in elementary school.
This time I've got I know this is such a bad run, but I still kind of care about it.
And now, I hear
there's some freak that looks a lot like B is showing his face all over Tokyo.
I don't know why I care about it, but likes to
play a little dress up. Ain't that a bit weird? He's running around spraying some crazy graffiti. Does he have any connection to the Golden Rhino? If the Golden Rhino is allowed to romp through the streets like this, Tokyo's done.
It really doesn't matter if I don't get Quick Claw. Like, it really doesn't. But yeah, at this point, we play as Clutch for the rest of the game.
There ain't no superhero to save the day in the world of the streets, baby. It's all up to you to take on the role for yourself.
Okay, I think we're good, actually. Yeah,
nice. Highway Zero is in a sea of flames. Golden Rhinos are laying waste to the street and showing no mercy. You gotta stop them.
I mean, it'd be nice to get Quick Claw, but it doesn't really matter for him. It's possible it can mean the difference between a 145 and a 146, but whatever.
The Golden Rhinos are throwing 20 Street into panic. Take down that twisted punk.
Okay, yeah. This is actually pretty bad though, because normally, like, I mean, I was only really talking about the second best thing apart from Quick Claw that it'd be okay to get. This is not even close to the second best. This is pretty bad. Actually, it's fine. I was wrong. It's actually fine. Because yeah, it's fine. If I had to knock him down again, that's where it gets super crap, but yeah, it's kind of fine right now. Could have boosted there, but whatever. But yeah, I am losing about 20 seconds because I didn't get Quick Claw. I definitely could have used that boost better, but probably should have used it in Shibuya. Oh dude, where am I going? But I could have used it like kind of at the beginning as well, I guess. Only 12 seconds, well. Well, yeah, that kinda makes sense actually. Because of different, like, ways of doing it with cans and stuff. Okay. It'd be nice if I get this, but it doesn't matter too much if I don't, but it really would be nice to get it. Thank you, game. I appreciate it. A lot. Okay. I really hope I don't fuck this up, but there's a pretty decent chance I will. Thank you. I'm so happy I got that. That soul is actually really annoying. He doesn't look like it, but it's actually one of the most annoying souls in the fucking game. I'll take it. Whatever. It works. But, yeah, I basically got a perfect FRZ, so. Might well be a pretty big goal, but we'll see. I don't know if these splits have me getting that. By the looks of it, they don't. I think this is probably a pretty big goal. But we'll see. As well. Yeah, they definitely don't have a good FRZ in these splits. He might be faster to drip jump, like, off the rail at some point, but I'm not really sure. Okay, yeah. Massive gold. Almost ahead of these splits. Well, okay. It'd be really nice to get this first try, but we'll see. We'll see. Okay, I did, nice. Now, the only things I've got to do now is remember to split, like, at the end of Highway Zero. Like, when I first get to Flames, I guess, which is why I split. And I need to remember to get the soul after Flames. And not be a fucking idiot like last time. Why I got that wrong. By the way, my splits are weird. Don't overthink it. That's another time save because I know Subrix didn't get it first try. The clip that is. I need more cannons, lol. Slow frames, but that's not particularly unusual, especially for default souls where you have like no cannons by that point. Okay, I'm so glad. It's in my brain not to miss this next soul. And that's why I'm not going to do it. It's possible I still missed a soul and I'm going to be pissed, but we'll see. It's in my brain to have not missed this soul, so I definitely shouldn't. My signal is fading quick. Okay, dude, really. Who the hell are you, sucker? We're gonna do the actual soul check though, going into train. Okay. This supposed time loss is just from like weird splitting times and whatnot. Okay, didn't shuffle. Lol.
Broadcasting as long as I can. The Golden Rhinos brought in some sort of strange looking machine. What is that thing? Shut that damn thing off.
I'm gonna have very few cans though. Like, I don't even have cans. Well, yeah, I have like no cans. I'm gonna just do old Zero Beat. Cause I kinda have to as well, I think. Okay. 139.43. Let me see what Subnick's got, because that's the only real reference point I have at the moment. So 149.43. Okay. So I am currently, I think, 2 minutes and 45 seconds ahead of Subnick's, which means that I'm on pace for a mid 145 IDT and a sub 150 RTA. So that's kind of lit. I'm so sure 144 is kind of free though. Super sure. Playing like absolute crap and getting a mid 145. 144 is very free, clearly. Okay, 3. That's kind of. Fuck it. We'll go for method 1. Okay, we'll do method 1. You can do method 1 with 0 pretty much, but it gets really kind of sketchy, honestly. Whatever, it's fine. It's all good. He did. Cool. Faster than normal Zerbi, or old Zerbi, I guess, so it's fine. GG wanted poster for the fans, why not?
Hold up. Wait a minute. I think I'ma call it.
Yeah. Oh, fuck. Damn it, I forgot to check my souls, so I'm gonna have to wait through the credits. Painfully waiting. That's pretty sad, not lie. Well, and it's up to you to decide what goes on. Dude, that credits wait is gonna be painful. It is. Fuck off, alien dude. 34 cans? Oof, okay. Let's just hope this goes alright. But yeah, this might not be world record, so we're just gonna have to see. Redeemed dab, oh fuck dude, okay. It's kinda hard to see, but that'll have to do. But yeah, we'll see. I can't think of any that I've missed, but it's always possible. So yeah. Thanks for the follow, Action Danger Man. I appreciate it.
Man's desires crumble as the tower was once again nothing more.
But yeah, you're gonna have to go through the painful process of waiting to see if it's actually world record. Extinguish the yearning for freedom. Because it's possible I've missed a soul or something.
Graffiti souls are the symbols of Tokyo's freedom. And the more people are pushed, the stronger that yearning for freedom becomes. And in the end, he was not strong enough to overcome that power. He had been doomed from the beginning. However, his existence might be nothing more than a symbol of the guilt that people feel for all their greed and desire. Or perhaps Tokyo has shown that it is one giant radio.
Never mind, you see it. Yeah, so here's the interesting thing. Okay, so officially the world record, and by the way, when I'm talking about this, I'm talking about the time in the top left, which is 1:45:28. So officially the world record is 1:48:25. So basically the other way around. but that's only the one that's on the leaderboards. I got a 147.28, but I, being an idiot, deleted the video, so I couldn't submit that to be verified or anything. So yeah, I did get a run where I missed one soul, which is the last soul that you have to pick up, and that was a low 146. So if I hadn't messed that up, the overall time would have been like a mid low, like more of a mid 146. So yeah, but yeah, technically world record is 147.28, but maybe I've lowered it by 2 minutes. We'll see. We'll have to wait until the credits are over to find out. Normally I would try and do a soul check in train, or like like in between talking to Zero Beat and going to train, but yeah, technically that's slower, but also I'm not cool to mods. The cool thing to do would be to make sure it is actually all the souls, and then just cut the video off before I show it. So then the mod has to go through making sure I got each soul. Well, I'm not that much of a dick. Gotta save those frames, yeah. It's like in ANS, right? Unless it's like an actual rule that you have to check. Couldn't you just get Jet on everything, get all the souls, get all the characters that you need, and then just make sure you actually got them all, but then just not show it. So the mod has to go through making sure you got everything. That's a really dick move. You don't have to show it. Dude, there are a lot of names here, honestly. But while I'm waiting, I'm just gonna check some stuff. I'm gonna put the sound back on because the sound wasn't on this whole run for me. Someone replied to me on something. Or commented or whatever, I don't know. Oh, someone just commented on my 34. That's all. Okay, nothing new on speedrun.com. Alright. Let's see. The moment of truth. Honestly, I'm not gonna lie. I would be pretty pissed off, but it would be really funny if I had 59 souls. I'm just gonna say, it would be, it genuinely would be funny. Okay, the moment of truth. Okay. Oh, dude. World record. World record. There it is. World record by 2 minutes. And officially, world record by 2 minutes and 57 seconds. Look at that, dude. 60 souls. That's how we do it. Okay, I'm gonna end the recording now.